thy sweet silver bells all seem to say, throw cares away. Christmas is here, bringing good cheer to young and old, meek and the bold. Ding, dong, ding, dong, that is their song, with joyful ring, all caroling.
One seems to hear words of good cheer from everywhere, feeling near.
Oh, how they pound, praising the sound, oh, your happy telephones. Gaily they ring, while people sing songs of good cheer.
Christmas is here, ding, dong, ding, dong, that is a song, with joyful ring, all caroling.
On they send, on without end, dear joyful tone, to every home. Hark how the bells, sweet silver bells, all seem to say, throw cares away. Christmas is here, bringing good cheer to young and old, meek and the bold. Ding, dong, ding, dong, that is their song, with joyful ring, all caroling.
One seems to hear words of good cheer from everywhere, filling the air.
Oh, how they come, praising the sound, oh,
happy tones. Gaily they ring, while people sing songs of good cheer. Christmas is here, ding, dong, ding, dong, that is their song, with joyful ring, all caroling.
Ding, on they send, on without end, dead joyful tone, to every home.
On they send, on without end, their joyful tone, to every home.
Ding, dong, ding, dong.
Boom.
Thank you.
In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, he said, "Hail, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what was said and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him the throne of David, his father, and he will rule over the house of Jacob forever. And of his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with a man?" And the angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her.
Stop. In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that the whole world should be enrolled. So all went to be enrolled, each to their own town. And Joseph, too, went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth to Judea, to the city of David, that is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and family of David, to be enrolled with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. While they were there, the time came for her to have her child. She gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in the manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
Thank you.
There were shepherds in that region, living in the field and keeping the night watch over the flock. The angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were struck with great fear. The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring to you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For today, in the city of David, a Savior has been born for you, who is Messiah and Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find an infant wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was a multitude of the heavenly hosts with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." When the angels went away from them to heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go, then, to Bethlehem to see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us."
Thank you. When Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of King Herod, behold, magi from the east arrived in Jerusalem, saying, "Where is the newborn King of the Jews? We saw his star at its rising and have come to do him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was greatly troubled, and all of Jerusalem with him. Assembling all the chief priests and the scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They said to him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it has been written through the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, since from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.'" Then Herod called the Magi secretly and ascertained from them the time of the star's appearance. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search diligently for the child. When you have found him, bring me word that I too may go and do him homage." After their audience with the king, they set out. And behold, the star that they had seen at its rising preceded them, until it came and stopped over the place where the child was. They were overjoyed at seeing the star, and on entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother. They prostrated themselves and did him homage. Then they opened their treasures and offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed for their country by another way.
That's me too.
sky, little lamb. Do you see what I see?
Was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came to be through him, and without him nothing came to be. What came to be through him was life, and this life was the light of the human race. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. A man named John was sent from God. He came for testimony, to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He was not the light, but came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came to be through him, but the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, but his own people did not accept him. But to those who did not accept him, he gave power. To those who did not accept him, he gave power to become children of God. To those who believe in his name, who were born not by natural generation, nor by human choice, nor by a man's decision, but of God. And the Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. And we saw his glory, the glory as of the Father's only Son, full of grace and truth.
Thank you.
the 25th day of December, when ages beyond number had run their course from the creation of the world, when God in the beginning created heaven and earth and formed man in his own likeness, when century upon century had passed since the Almighty set his bow in the clouds after the great flood, as a sign of covenant and peace. In the 21st century, since Abraham, our father in faith, came out of the Ur of the Chaldees. In the 13th century, since the people of Israel were led by Moses in the Exodus from Egypt. Around the 1,000th year, since David was anointed king. In the 65th week of the prophecy of Daniel, in the 194th Olympiad, in the year 752 since the foundation of the city of Rome, in the 42nd year of the reign of Caesar Octavian Augustus, the whole world being at peace. Jesus Christ, eternal God and Son of the eternal Father, desiring to consecrate the world by his most loving presence, was conceived by the Holy Spirit, and when 9 months had passed since his conception, was born of the Virgin Mary in Bethlehem of Judah, and was made man. The Nativity of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to the flesh.
Merry Christmas. Please rise and join in singing our gathering song, O Come All Ye Faithful.
Come, O ye faithful, joyful and triumphant, O come, ye all come, ye to Bethlehem.
warm welcome to everyone to St. Ignatius Cathedral this evening as we come together to celebrate what is the center of our faith, the birth of the Lord. God has become one of us. As we celebrate that, he truly becomes flesh upon the altar this evening in the Eucharist, and he feeds us with his body and his blood as we continue on our journey. We give thanks to God for this great gift as we begin in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us now acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, who art mighty God and Prince of Peace, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, who art Son of God and Son of Mary, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, who are Word made flesh and splendor of the Father, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who have made this most sacred night radiant with the splendor of the true light, grant, we pray, that we who have known the mysteries of his light on earth may also delight in his goodness in heaven, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
The people who walk in darkness have seen a great light. On those who dwell burden them, the toll on their shoulder, and the rod of their taskmaster. You have snatched as on the day of Midian. For every boot that tramped in battle, for every cloak rolled in blood, will be burned as fuel for flames. For a child is born to us, a son is given us, upon his shoulder dominion rests. They name him Wonder Counselor, God Hero, Father Forever, Prince of Peace. His dominion is vast and forever peaceful. From David's throne and over his kingdom, which he confirms and sustains by justice and judgment, both now and forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Savior, Christ the Lord. Today is born our Savior, Christ the Lord.
Today is born our Savior, Christ the Lord. Today is born our Savior, Christ the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to Titus. Beloved, when the kindness and generous love of God, our Savior, appeared, not because of any righteous deeds we have done, but because of his mercy, he saved us through the bath and the rebirth and renewal by the Holy Spirit, whom he richly poured out on us through Jesus Christ our Savior. So that we might justified by his grace and become heirs in hope of eternal life. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
From the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that the whole world should be enrolled. This was the first enrollment of Quirinius, who was the governor of Syria. So all went to be enrolled, each to his own town. And Joseph too went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth, to Judea, to the city of David, that is called Bethlehem, because he was the house of the family David, to be enrolled with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. While they were there, the time came for her to have her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Now there were shepherds in that region living in the fields and keeping night watch over their flock. The angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were struck with great fear. The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I proclaim to you good news of great joy that there will be for all the people. For today, in the city of David, a Savior has been born for you, who is the Christ and Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find an infant wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was a multitude of heavenly hosts with the angel praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. As you may know, our Holy Father, Pope Francis, just less than 2 weeks ago, called for a special year, a year in honor of Saint Joseph. And how fitting it is that we celebrate this Christmas during this year of Saint Joseph. It began on December 8th, the Feast of the Immaculate Conception, as it was the 150th anniversary of Saint Joseph being named the patron of the Church, Universal Church, and it will conclude on December 8th of 2021. The Pope reminded us, in giving us this year in honor of Saint Joseph, of the role that Saint Joseph plays in the life of Christ, in the life of Mary, and in the life of each and every one of us. Because as the Pope says, we can all identify with Saint Joseph. Saint Joseph was a man who was very much involved in the daily things of life, taking care of his family, looking after what had to be taken care of each and every day. and a man who seemed in the background, a man who was not well known at all, a man who made a tremendous difference in the life of the world. As we just listened to the gospel this evening from St. Luke, that gospel portrays very well the central role of St. Joseph in the birth of Christ, not only at his presence in the manger, but also because it was because of Joseph that they were able to go to Bethlehem, because Joseph was the descendant of David, the town of Bethlehem. And it was through Joseph's central role that the birth of Christ took place in that fashion. As we celebrate this Christmas, and we receive Christmas cards, and we look at beautiful images of the Nativity, it is good for us, perhaps this year in a special way, to look at St. Joseph. I know on my own part, so many cards I receive, so many beautiful scenes of the Nativity I've come in contact with, so many works of art, that many times I fail to notice, not St. Joseph, but the details of St. Joseph, especially what St. Joseph is holding in his hands in the Nativity. St. Joseph, like all of us, is a man who had his hands full. A man with full hands, with all many things to take care of, to look after, to worry about. But his hands were full always with the right things, and that made the difference. If we look at our Nativity here this evening and the one outside, Joseph is holding what we usually see him holding in the manger, a staff. A shepherd's staff, many times it is portrayed as. But Joseph was not a shepherd. He was a carpenter. So why would Joseph be holding a staff? The reason is a simple one. The staff gave St. Joseph support. In going from Nazareth to Bethlehem, that was a journey along roads in which he needed to lean upon the staff. Joseph was more advanced in years than Mary. Joseph needed that support. And that staff which St. Joseph is holding represents the sacrifice that he made, not only in terms of giving of himself in a total way to the Lord, but also in terms of his physical disability, upon which he had to rely on that staff. And he did so without any hesitation. And that's a reminder to us that in our own lives, we need to take advantage of those means of assistance which are given to us to help us with our full hands each and every day. And the central need of our life for assistance is our relationship with the Lord. The Lord who this evening we celebrate has become one of us. God who took our human flesh to himself. God who became like one of us in everything but sin. He is central to our lives. Without Christ, without his becoming one of us, without his being in our lives, we easily lose the way. At this difficult time of which we have been going through, it is our faith, it is our hope, it is our belief in the person of Jesus Christ that makes all the difference. Let us never hesitate to lean upon him. He wants us to. Never let us hesitate to realize our relationship with him who loves us so much that he became one of us is central to our lives. As the years progressed in the history of the church, the staff which St. Joseph holds many times became a royal staff because, as I said, Joseph was the direct descendant of David, and that is how Jesus' descendancy from David comes about through Joseph. King David was a royal figure. And in order to acknowledge that royalty of his descendancy, which Joseph had, many times the staff is imagined as a royal staff. Joseph had royalty. But Joseph's royalty was not one in which he lorded it over others. Joseph's royalty was one of humility, of realizing that he was a tremendous gift from God. Realizing that he depended upon God, realizing that God was the center, realizing that it wasn't what he that made the difference, but God that made the difference. That's the royalty. That's the dignity that we all possess. Today, in his homily for Christmas Eve earlier today, which took place in Rome this evening at 8 o'clock, The Holy Father said to the crowd gathered there, a small crowd, obviously, that many times in our lives we may feel that we're useless, that we're on the side, that we don't matter, that we don't count. The Pope said, whenever we feel that way, let us always remember that through the birth of Jesus Christ, God is looking at us and saying, you are amazing. You are amazing in who you are, and I will never turn away from you. And it is I who confer a dignity upon you. Despite your limitations, despite your sins, despite your failures, you are amazing, and I love you. I love you, and I will never abandon you. I have become one of you. That's the royalty. That's the dignity that we possess. That's the dignity that St. Joseph possessed, which we can never forget. Many times in depictions of St. Joseph, you'll see him holding a lantern. An obvious reason for that, the cave was dark, the manger was dark, he needed light. However, that lantern represents the light of the world, who is Jesus Christ. That as we celebrate on this evening the birth of Christ, it is he who came into the world, and even though that star of Bethlehem, the star of David, appeared, he overshone that star as the light which casts out the shadows. How much we need the light of Christ in our lives and in our world today. With so much confusion, with so much competition, with so much of a lack of understanding of what the meaning of life is all about, it is Christ. It is Christ who is the light. Joseph did not hesitate to let that light shine upon him and to be an instrument of that light which would come to others. Many times you'll see Joseph holding a lily, or many times on top of the staff there will be a lily. That lily represents the virtue of Joseph's life. It represents his relationship with Mary. And in our own lives, we realize that there is a virtue that is needed in our lives each and every day as we follow Christ and set example for others. Sometimes, not often, in the manger scene, we will actually see Joseph holding the Christ child and Mary looking at him holding the Christ child. More frequently, there are depictions of Jesus holding the Christ child in other situations, but many times when he is doing that, he's holding the tool of the carpenter's square, representing who Joseph was, the carpenter, but representing that he was a man of work. Work is a gift from God. Rather than say work, we should say occupation. We all have an occupation in life, whether we're working, whether we're retired, whether we're young, whether we're middle-aged, whether we're older. An occupation in which we participate in the creativity of God. The first time we encounter God in the scriptures, he is creating, he is working, and he's described as that way. He rests on the seventh day. And God made us so that we could work with him, occupy ourselves with him each and every day, enter into his creativity and make a difference in the world, not because of what we do, but because of our relationship with him. We look to St. Joseph as he stands in the crib, as he sometimes holds the Christ child, and he has that carpenter's tool in his hand and realize that each and every one of us have a dignity given to us by God. No one else confers that dignity upon us. Each and every one of us, no matter who we are, no matter what our age may be, have an occupation. And we occupy ourselves in the creativity of God if we see things through the light, through the lantern of Jesus Christ. As we celebrate Christmas this year, let us do so giving thanks to God for the gift of his becoming one of us, for the gift of his love, for the gift of the child Jesus. And in a special way during this year of St. Joseph, let us look to Joseph, his foster father, the husband of Mary, and realize that Joseph is like us, as the Pope tells us, in so many things. We can easily identify with him.
And as we do so, we realize that in our lives, we don't have to be famous. We don't have to be known by others. We can be on the side. But what's important is we are on the side because we are with Christ. Joseph made all the difference in the world, and each and every one of us can do the same, not because of what we accomplish, but because of who we are in the person of Jesus Christ and drawing deeply, more deeply into that relationship and coming to know ourselves. We ask St. Joseph, as we ask the Blessed Virgin Mary, to help us to look upon the Son of God and in following him each and every day, know the freedom which only the Lord can give us. May God bless each and every one of you, and through the intercession of St. Joseph during this special year dedicated to him, may you have a blessed Christmas, always in the knowledge of the presence of God among us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. And now, as a family of faith, centered upon the table of the Lord, we profess what we believe. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified on the Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. With faith and confidence in God, our loving Father, who has given us his Son, we turn to him now with our prayers and our needs, knowing he will look upon us in his love and answer us as he knows best.
For Pope Francis, may God continue to bless him with vitality as he shepherds his flock, the Church. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For legislators and policymakers, may the Lord guide their decision-making in order to protect the lives of the unborn. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who feel lonely this Christmas season, may Jesus bring them comfort. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all families gathered here today, as we seek to emulate the model of the Holy Family of Nazareth, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all the faithful departed, may they rejoice in heaven with the risen Christ and all the angels and saints. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Thomas Ann Lyons, who remember in this liturgy this evening, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving Father, as we offer you the perfect gift, the gift of your Son upon this altar this evening, we join ourselves to him. We ask that you continue to look upon us in your love and to hear the prayers we ask in his name, who lives with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May the oblation of this day's feast be pleasing to you, O Lord, we pray, that through this most sacred exchange we may be found in the likeness of Christ, in whom our nature is united to you, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for in the mystery of the Word made flesh, a new light of your glory has shone upon the eyes of our mind, so that we, as recognizing in him God made visible, may be caught up through him in love of things invisible. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy.
Holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord, Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world,
and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Gerald our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Peace, Bishop. Peace, Brian.
Peace, peace. Peace be with you. Peace, John. Peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. the body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
The body of Christ.
The body of Christ.
The body of Christ.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Thank you.
the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of the dear Savior's birth. The world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul
Let us pray. Grant us, we pray, O Lord our God, that we who are gladdened by participating in the feast of our Redeemer's Nativity may through an honorable way of life become worthy of union with him who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
I want to thank Father Gavin and all those here at the cathedral, all of the staff for the wonderful job that they've done during the season of Advent and at this Christmas time, the beautiful decoration of the church. In a special way, I want to thank our fine, fine music ministry this evening. They did a great job to help us pray. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. And again, to all of you and to your families, a most blessed Christmas. With the promise that the Lord has given us, we know, we have the hope, that he is with us, and our faith makes all the difference in the world. May God bless you, and may you know the peace and the joy of the born Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Now and forever.
Our help is in the name of the Lord.
Who made heaven.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. The Mass is ended. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God. God bless you.
He rules the world with truth.